This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, good afternoon, students. Today we are going to discuss about two area low frequency control with static response and control case. So already we did the derivation based on the single area system. So single area system already man chesam for both static response and dynamic response. Now we are going to derive that as the same thing, static response for a two area control system. So how we can proceed for a two area control system, what are the precautions we have to do? So that is the thing we are going to derive in today's class. So all of you just meeku paper ready pettukondi notes. So meeru no derive chestunte vastane you can understand the derivation. So just chustu unte meeku artham kadu. So all of you take that notes and just what I am going to derive, that same thing you have to note that. So I'm going to start the class now. So this is the representation of two area system. Here it is a area 1 and it is area 2, and the both are coupled with a tie line, that is mentioned this one. Now we are going to find the static response for this two area block diagram. Now we will see that how we can proceed the two area system for finding the static response, and that is for uncontrolled case. Okay, na? So this is the derivation we are going to derive now. Now what are the conditions for uncontrolled case? What are the conditions for uncontrolled case? So the delta PC equals to 0, that is the changing in the speed change, it had to be keep constant, and the changes should be equals to 0, and the only variable is load demand. Yeah, so that is the thing, it is belongs to the uncontrolled case. See, uncontrolled case, I am going to again say that when the controlling action is not in our hand, that may call as uncontrolled case. So suppose the load variation is not in our hand, right? So sometimes it may be increase, sometimes it may be decrease. So that's why the uncontrolled case, the variable parameter is given by that load demand. Now let me see that in this condition also we have some certain assumptions. After that we will proceed the derivation. Right. See, these are the three conditions we have to assume while solving this static response for the two area system. The first one is, for uncontrolled case, the speed changer which is belongs to area 1 and area 2, we have to keep 0. And the only variable is load demand, that is delta PD. So here, the meaning of we are assuming 0 means there is no need to change position of speed changer. So we are not supposed to do any changes in the speed changer. So we have to keep that constant. That's why it becomes 0. Suppose there is any sudden change in load demand in 2 years, that was mentioned by that delta PD1 and delta PD2. So delta is nothing but it is a variable parameter. So variable parameter in the sense the load should be keep on going to changes with respect to the time. And here frequency drops in the steady state, and those drops will be equal to. So here when the load demand, when the load was changes, the frequency will be there drops, and if drops and frequency and change avutundi. So how it will be changed means by request, by assumption that delta frequency, that is a variable frequency of area 1 is equals to variable frequency of area 2, and finally it is two areas frequency is equals to delta of stat. So this is the frequency drop we equal to that area 1 frequency and area 2 frequency. These are the three assumptions we have to it needs to required for derivation of static response of a two area control system. Now we are going to proceed the derivation by using the block diagram. Right. So at steady state condition we will have that. See, already we have seen that when the frequency was under condition, that is under that variation condition, then the system is called a steady state condition. Steady state condition, we can represent this is the conditions that will have the incremental tie line power. Delta Pg1 static is equal to minus 1 by R delta F tag. See, how we can obtain this means, this is the parameter. See, if you observe this, here we are getting the delta Pg1. At a steady state condition, we will get that the delta 1 minus 1 by R1 delta F tag. It means that it is under controlling. So the regulation frequency was under controlling, then the system is called as steady state condition. So here, when the system will be called as steady state condition means when the delta Pg1 stat is equal to minus 1 by R1 delta F stat. So delta F stat means this is the feedback from output, right? So delta Pg1 the output is coming to the feedback and it is multiplied with 1 by R1. So it is connected to the negative feedback. So at steady state condition, we are representing the static response. It is equal, the delta Pg1 is equal to minus, so it is connected to the minus here, minus 1 by R1 into delta F stat. At steady state condition, all assumptions should be equal to 1. So final value theorem apply in tarvata S terms 0 aipothundi. When S plus 0 aipnodu, you will get the only 1. So if 1 is chesinappudu, the entire term is multiplied with 1, then you will get the these two parameters with respect to area 1 and area 2. So represent it is equation 1. So if equation 1 paine mattam derivation ani dependent. So note it down, this is the equation 1. And this equation represents the steady state condition. So steady state condition man kavalante we the power generation it must to be equal to that feedback error. Okay na? Just note down this equation one. Now let me see that this is the initial conditions. Now by using this equation 1, how we can obtain that final variation in the frequency? Right. From the block diagram of two area low frequency control system. Now this is the equation. So let me consider that from the block. So this is the block diagram. I am going to derive the first by using the area 1. So automatically we will get the area 2 also. So first I am considering that area 1. So here the final output is delta F of S. So this is our final output. So the delta F of S is equal to this 3. So here Pg1 minus P tie 1 minus delta Pd1 into Kp divided by 1 plus S. So here we are not bothered about this value. Why? Because Tg value, Tt value already manaku known values. So we had to find only Kp and Tp. Already manaku ninna problem chesam. So problem lo manaku Tg, the time constant for governor, the time constant for turbine already mention chesaru. But we found that the value of Kp and Tp. So ikkada manaku unknown values vachesi only below Kp value and Tp value. So that's why we are taking the consideration in the derivation only Kp 1 divided by 1 plus STP parameter alone. Now, from this block diagram, I need to find the equation. So, delta F1 of S is output. Now, this equation, so delta F1 of S is equal to, here, the summation adding that the three parameters. One is delta Pg1, delta Pd1, and delta P tie 1 of S. So, here our plus or minus. So, now we can represent delta Pg1 static minus delta Pd1 minus delta. So, here plus minus minus. Three terms change tarvata. These three terms is multiplied with Kp1 divided by 1 plus Stp1 is equal to delta F stat. Okay, now here the Kp, the constant Kp value we can find by using the 1 by beta, 1 by B. What is the formula for B? How we can find the value of B? How we can find the value of B, capital B? So here I am substituting, instead of Kp is equals to 1 by B and Tp is equals to 2h divided by Fb. These are the two parameters, that is one is gain constant and time constant of generator. I am substituting these two values in this equation, then you will get 1 by B1 divided by 1 plus 2h divided by Fb1 into S delta F tag. Now from this equation, just cross multiply that Fb1 plus 2h divided by Fb1. Okay, now in this equation, which parameter will get cancelled? In this third equation, the one factor is going to be cancelled. What is it? Right. So here B1 get cancelled. Then we will have 1 divided by B1 plus 2HS divided by F. This is the term we will get after eliminating this B1 and B1, numerator and denominator B1. Now this is what we get the transfer function here. Now let me see after this step what we will get. Right. See, after eliminating that B1 in numerator and denominator, we are obtaining that B1 plus 2HS divided by F. Now, this entire equation I am going to be cross multiplied with here. Then we will get B1 plus 2H divided by F into delta H tag. Now, this the right hand side term I am going to expand it. So we have two factors. One is B1 and 2H by F. So these two factors was multiplied with delta F stat, we will get this one. So B1 delta F stat plus 2HSF delta F stat. Now, when compared to these two terms, it is completely zero value. So zero value in the sense, it is higher value and it should be negligible. So just keep it is equals to zero. Now, finally, the equation which is equals to that B1 delta F stat. Now, the power, the tail end power for area 1. So make this, so this term is bring this side and this one is bring this side. So delta PT1 is equal to delta PG1 static minus delta PD1 minus B1 delta F star. Represent it is equation 2. Now at the same time, for area 2, what we will get? For area 2, so write this equation for area 2. So what you will get? Delta PG2 stat minus delta PD2 minus delta P tie 1 stat. Sorry, tie 2 stat equals to B2 into delta F star. So this is the equation for area 2. So write down up to equation 2 here. Now, so this is the equation, that is tail end power for the area 1. సో మనకి ఇక్కడ ఏరియా వన్ కి థైలైన్ పవర్ అనేది ఈ వాల్యూస్ బేస్ చేసుకుని వస్తుంది డెల్టా పిజి వన్ స్టాటిక్ మైనస్ డెల్టా పిడి వన్ అంటే యాక్చువల్ గా దిస్ ఇస్ ద వాల్యూ ఆఫ్ జనరేషన్ ఆఫ్ పవర్ ఫ్రమ్ ఫర్ ఏరియా వన్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద లోడ్ డిమాండ్ అండ్ దిస్ ఇస్ ద వేరియబుల్ ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ హ్యాపెన్ ఇన్ ద ఏరియా వన్ ఇఫ్ యూ కంబైన్ దిస్ త్రీ వాల్యూస్ అండ్ వీ విల్ గెట్ దట్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద థైలైన్ పవర్ దట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద పవర్ షేరింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఏరియా వన్ సో మొత్తం ఇదంతా అయిపోయిన తర్వాత ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ద జనరేషన్ కెపాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ప్లాంట్ ఇస్ 220 మెగావాట్ అనుకుందాం అండ్ ద పవర్ డిమాండ్ ఇస్ 15 అండ్ రిమైనింగ్ ద ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ వేరియేషన్ డ్యూ టు ద ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ వేరియేషన్ వీ విల్ గెట్ అప్రాక్సిమేట్లీ 3 సో ఆఫ్టర్ దిట్ ఫైనల్ యూ విల్ గెట్ దట్ 2 మెగావాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ దట్ ద పవర్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ఏరియా వన్ ఇట్ ఈస్ సపోజ్ టు అండ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కేపబుల్ టు డెలివర్ దట్ 2 మెగావాట్ టు ద ఏరియా 2 ఓకేనా సో ఇవన్నీ పోంగా అంటే ఆ పర్టికులర్ లోడ్ యొక్క డిమాండ్ పోంగా రిమైనింగ్ మిగిలిన బ్యాలెన్స్ ఏమైనా ఉంటే దెన్ ద పవర్ ఏరియా వన్ ఇస్ రెడీ టు డెలివర్ దట్ రిమైనింగ్ పవర్ ఆఫ్టర్ కంప్లీషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ లోడ్ డిమాండ్ ఓకేనా సో అప్పుడు ఇదంతా అయిపోయిన తర్వాత దెన్ ద ఏరియా వన్ హ్యాస్ టు బి డెలివర్ దిస్ లోడ్ టు దిస్ నైబర్ ఏరియాస్ ఓకేనా సో ఈ విధంగా అంటే థైలైన్ పవర్ అంటే దానికి సంబంధించిన లోడ్ డిమాండ్ పోగా మిగిలినది ఎంత ఉంటుందో ఆ వాల్యూ అండ్ ఆ పవర్ అనేది ఇట్ విల్ గోయింగ్ టు బి షేర్ టు నైబర్ ఏరియాస్ ఓకేనా సో దట్ ఈస్ ద ఈక్వేషన్ వాస్ గివెన్ బై ఈక్వేషన్ 2 నౌ ఫర్ ద సేమ్ ఈక్వేషన్ హౌ వి కెన్ రైట్ ఫర్ ఏరియా 2 లెట్ మీ సీ దట్ Right. Similarly, for area 2, we can write like this. Delta P, so instead of 1, we are just substitute the 2 here. Now, this term should bring this side. Now, we will get B2 delta F stat and delta P tie 1 stat. Now, this is the definition of Thailand power 2. Now, this entire term, I want to be bring it to the related to the area 1. So, how we can write means by using this relation. So this is the tie line of 2-1. That is tie line with respect to that area 2 to area 1. And it is equal to minus A1. So this is the term. So this is the parameter act as vital role in the tie line power. So while converting this area 2 to area 1, I just want to substitute this tie line parameter minus A12. Now, this in this equation, we can write minus A12 delta P tie 1. Static. So already we have the equation of this one. So delta P tie 1. So already my previous value only. So let me see what is the value. So this is the value. So substitute equation 2 here. So substitute equation 2, then you will get the equation delta PG stat minus delta PD 2 is equal to the entire equation. Represent it is equation 3. Now after substituting of so ippudu manaku ee relation ela vastundante it is a combination of delta power that is a power generation from area 1 as well as area 2 so equation 3 is represents that the power and frequency changes with respect to area 1 and area 2 okay so manaki equation chuste complete ga three parameters vachesayi edi power generation with respect to the area 2 and area 1 load demand with respect to the area 2 and area 1 and frequency changes with respect to the area 2 and area 1 so now from this equation we are going to derive the final equation by using the equation 1 now already we have the equation 1 and the equation 2 what we have delta pg 2 static we have right so let me see that what is the equation here See, already we have from equation 1, what we have? So, from equation we have delta PG1 equals to minus 1 by R 1 delta F stat. similarly for area to delta PG2 stat equals to minus 1 by R2 delta F stat. Now this is the representation of equation 1. Now we are going to substitute equation 1 and equation 3 in the form of, so in the place of delta PG2 stat and delta PG1 stat. So ee place lo manamu ee rendu equation substitute cheyabothunnam. See here, now substitute that equation 1, and so if you substitute here, then we will get instead of delta PG1 stat minus R1, ఈ డెల్టా స్టాట్ మైనస్ డెల్టా ఎఫ్ టు. సో ఈ విధంగా సబ్మిట్ చేసాం. సో చేసిన తర్వాత దెన్ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు మేక్ దట్ ఏ కామన్ టర్మ్ విచ్ ఇస్ రిలేటెడ్ టు ద డెల్టా ఎఫ్ స్టాట్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ లెట్ సీ దట్ వాట్ విల్ గెట్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ టేక్ ద డెల్టా ఎఫ్ స్టాట్ ఈస్ కామన్ ఆన్ బోత్ సైడ్స్ వి విల్ గెట్ ద ఎంటైర్ టర్మ్ హియర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు డెల్టా పిడి టు ప్లస్ ఏ వన్ టు డెల్టా పిడి వన్. నౌ ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఫైనల్లీ వీ కెన్ అపెండ్ డెల్టా ఎఫ్ స్టాట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు minus of delta PD2 plus A1 to delta PD1 divided by. So in this equation, if you observe this equation, these two are constant and these two terms are which related to the tail end parameter. Now I am going to write this equation while using that normal term and with the tail end parameter B2 plus 1 by R1 plus A1 to B1 plus 1 by R1. This is equation 4. Now when compared to that B2 and R1, B1 and R1, which is having the more value? Out of B1 and R1, which one is having more value? So already manamu single area system chesam. When compared to the B1 is 1 by R1. So when compared to that, these two parameters, that is B1 and 1 by R1, it is less than or equal, less than to 1 by R1. So after we have to eliminate this B1 value. So if you eliminate that B1 value, you will get that 1 divided by 1 by R1, then you will get R1 value. So this is the relation between that B1 and R1. Now this is the representation of equation 4. From this equation 4, we are going to eliminate that B2 and B1. If you eliminate this B1 and B2, what you will get? See, from equation 2, so up to this, okay, I'll leave it that equation of 4. Now from equation 2, so what is the equation 2? So we have the equation 2 is delta P tie 1 static is equals to delta PG1 stat minus delta PD1 minus B1 F stat. So this is the equation we have from equation 2. Now in this equation 2, I am going to substitute that the value of delta PG1 is given by minus 1 by R1 delta F star. Now from this equation, these two terms having the delta F star, just substitute, just take common, and we have minus of delta F star into B1 plus 1 by R1 minus delta PD. Definitely it is equation 5. Now already we have the equation 4, that is the delta F star. So what we have the delta F star value? So here we have the delta F stat is, so this is the term. Minus of delta PD2 plus A1 to delta PD1 divided by B2 plus 1 by R1 R2 plus A1 to B1 plus 1 by R1. So this is the delta F stat already we found in equation 4. Now substitute 4 and 5. If you substitute here, minus minus will get cancelled, then you will get the positive value. So delta P tai 1 stat is equals to, instead of delta F stat, I am substituting this equation. So A already minus is there, and this minus minus to minus will get plus, and finally we will get that entire term into B1 plus 1 by R1 minus delta P D1. Now in this equation, what I am going to means, so just expand this entire term. So entire term into B1 plus entire term into so even the multiplication. So delta PD1 T2 plus A1 to delta PD1 into B1 plus 1 by R1 minus of delta PD into the entire denominator will comes to the upside. So then, so this is the first term and second term. Divide by the whole term, you will get the denominator. Now in this term, there are two terms are going to be cancelled. That is A1 to delta PD1, this term and this term will get cancelled. Then you have only delta PD2 B1 plus 1 by R1 minus delta PD1 B1 plus 1 by R1 divided by what we have the denominator, the same term will be get here. So just note down this equation. Now in this equation, what we have to eliminate that lesser parameter. So already I told you that when compared to that B and 1 by R, so here the B value is less than the 1 by R, that's why we have to eliminate this B value. Then we will get that 1 by R1 and 1 by R2. Now from this equation, let me see that what you will get. So here already we know that the value of beta, so the combination of B and 1 by B1 and 1 by R1, so we can substitute beta 1 similarly for beta 2. So if you substitute this one, the equation will becomes delta PD2 beta 1 minus delta PD1 to beta 2. Now from this equation, the finally we will get that delta F stat is equals to minus of delta PD2 plus A PD1 divided by beta 2 plus A1 to beta. So ikkada numerator ane change avutundi. Why? Because when you substituting that beta 1, so ikkada B1 plus 1 by R1 undu kada, so if you substitute here 1 by R1 here, then you will get that delta F stat. Okay, na endukante manaku already starting on the delta P tai 1 stat is equals to minus of 1 by R1 delta F stat. Okay, na so aa place manamu just delta F stat ni ee vidhanga rasukochu. So here already in starting we discussed that this is the situation, it is working in the steady state condition. Steady state conditions in the sense the parameters which is involving in the both area 1 and area 2 which are working in the synchronism manner. That's why for two identical cases we have to be assume beta 1 equals to beta 2 and both parameters equals to beta, and similarly R1 R2 equals to R, B1 B2 equals to B, and already we have that when the two areas are synchronous in both in synchronously, when then we have to assume that the tail end parameter A12 is equals to 1. If you substitute these four parameters in above equation, we will get delta F stat is equals to minus of delta PD2 plus delta PD1 divided by 2B. Now we will see that After this delta F cat, what is the frequency with respect to the area one? Right. So here, suppose a stop load change occurs at area one, what we have to be choose delta PD2 equals to 0. Endukante ikkada manamu area one gurinchi maatladutunnam. So it means that the entire process which was related to that area one. Now, from this equation, the above equation, in this equation, we can substitute delta PD equals to 0. Then we have delta F stat is equals to minus delta PD1 divided by 2 beta. So beta is equals to B plus 1 by R, right? So here B is eliminated, we will get 1 by R. So finally, we will get R in numerator divided by 2. So this is the equation we can write. Delta P tie 1 static is equals to minus delta P D 1 divided by 2. So this is the variation of power. This is the variation of frequency with respect to the area 1. And this is the area of power with respect to the area 1. Now, for the same equation, if you write for area 2, what you will get? Let's see. So I'm going to write this same equation with respect to the area 2. So we will get delta F stat equals to delta PD2 minus 2 divided by 2 beta HZ. So minus will be there. So this is the condition when we contain means when there is a step load change occurs in area 2. So other condition we can substitute delta PD1 is equals to 0. At the same time, the tie end power from area 2 we can get minus delta PD2 divided by 2. So this is the equation we derived for static response of a uncontrolled system for two area load frequency control. సో మీకు యాక్చువల్ గా టూ మల్టీ ఏరియా కంట్రోల్ సిస్టమ్ అనేది థర్డ్ ఇంట్లో పార్ట్ బి కిందకి వస్తుంది. సో మీకు పార్ట్ ఏ తో కలిస్తే పార్ట్ బి కొంచెం కాంప్లికేటెడ్ గా డెరివేషన్స్ ఉంటాయి. సో ఎందుకంటే ఈ టూ లైన్ పవర్ లో మీకు టూ డెరివేషన్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఒకటి స్టాటిక్ రెస్పాన్స్ ఫర్ అన్కంట్రోల్ కేస్ అండ్ డైనమిక్ రెస్పాన్స్ ఫర్ అన్కంట్రోల్ కేస్. ఆఫ్టర్ దాట్ దెర్ ఆర్ టూ మోర్ టాపిక్స్ ఆఫ్ దే. వాట్ ఆర్ ద టూ టాపిక్స్ మీన్స్ టైల్ అండ్ బయాస్ కంట్రోల్ వన్ and proportional integral one. So these two we have to be derived. So enga manaki intlo 3-4 derivations unnai, okay na? So just simple how we can remember the derivations and one thing, you just to remember that what is the block diagram representation. So if you know the block diagram representation, it is very easy to convert that block diagram into derivation part, okay na? So in that just I want to tell you that, so meer ee condition ee vidhanga derivation solve cheyalante you should remember that the only thing is only the condition. First one is conditions. So what are the condition is for it is static response control case. So first one is static response. For uncontrolled case, what are the assumptions? We have delta PC equals to 0 and delta PD is variable. So these two assumptions we have to assume for uncontrolled case. For control case, what we have to assume? Delta PD equals to 0 and delta PC is variable. And this is the equation for control case. After assumption this two parameters in the block diagram, we have to rearrange the block diagram. After that, we have to substitute a step change in the load demand. So for step change, we have to assume delta PD by S. After that, we have to apply the final value theorem. It was given by delta F stat is equals to limit S tends to 0, S into delta PD of S. So we submit and then we will get that delta F. So this is for static response. So for static response, we have to apply the final value theorem. Now similarly, let me see the dynamic response. For dynamic response, again it has the two conditions. One is controlled case, another one is uncontrolled case. The same parameters we have to be assumed in controlled case and uncontrolled case. If it is controlled case, we have to be choose that variable parameter is speed changer and constant value is load demand. If it is uncontrolled case, we have to choose the constant value is speed changer and it is becomes to zero and variable parameter is that is load demand. Now after substitution of these all values, we will make that block diagram into transfer function, that is in terms of output by input is equals to plant, that is transfer function, right? So after that, here we are going to use this solving this derivation by using the partial fraction expansion. So after partial fraction expansion, we are going to find that we are splitting that higher order term to the single order. So actually one was even one of block diagram ni reference chesinappudu we will get that higher order S term. So when it is has a higher order, it is difficult to find. So we have to be split up by using the partial fraction. Then we will get that single S term. So after that S term, we have to be use inverse Laplace transform. Then you will get that in exponential form. So these are the steps we used in the single area control system. At the same time, we can use in the multi area, that is two area control system. Okay now? Right, this is about today's class, students. We discussed static response of uncontrolled case in a two-area system. In tomorrow class, we are going to derive that dynamic response of a two-area system. Right. So do you have any doubts in this? And one more thing I want to tell you that this is the concept is very useful for your project. So if you want to do the final project, you can do number of applications based on this load frequency control. Endukante present maximum a ante oka project cheyalante there is a more chances to do the project on load frequency control. We can use the different algorithms for finding the load frequency control, you know. So adi ela cheyachante just I will give the just oka idea istanu chudandi. So just meeru load frequency oka 30, so we have the number of bus systems in our power system, 33 bus, 15 bus, so remaining that. And if you want to control that 33 bus by using load frequency control, so how we can control the 33 bus means, first of all, if you want to proceed that this method, first of all we have to identify that in 33 bus, in what bus having that major losses. So major losses అనేవి ఏ బస్ దగ్గర అక్కడ అవుతున్న ఐడెంటిఫై చేయాలి. సో ఫర్ ఫైండింగ్ ద ఐడెంటిఫికేషన్ ఆఫ్ లాసెస్ వి హావ్ దమ్ డిఫరెంట్ టైప్స్ ఆఫ్ అల్గారిథమ్స్ దట్ ఇస్ జెంటిక్ అల్గారిథమ్, పార్టికల్ సమ్ ఆప్టిమైజేషన్, ఇంక్రిమెంటల్ అనాలిసిస్. సో వి హావ్ దట్ డిఫరెంట్ అల్గారిథమ్స్. బై యూజింగ్ దట్ అల్గారిథమ్స్ వి కెన్ ఫైండ్ దట్ అట్ 33 బస్ ఇన్ విచ్ బస్ హావింగ్ ద మోర్ లాసెస్. ఆఫ్టర్ ఫౌండ్ ద లాసెస్ we have to use the remedial methods. So remedial measures endante we just to plus the distribution system ante distribution generation cheyal. So can you say example for distribution generation? Can you say example for distribution generation? what we call distributed generation, where we want distributed generation antaru. What we call distribution generation. So I will give some examples on distributed generation. These are, the first one is solar plant. Wind power plant. And for third one is geothermal. So these are the some example for distribution generation. So by after finding the losses, we will get that idea. So at particular area, we had to place that distribution generation for making that low demand. Okay, na? Ante aa power ni catch up cheyalanta man DG ni pay chesam. సో ఇలాంటి ప్రాజెక్ట్స్ మనము లో ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ కంట్రోల్ పైన చేయొచ్చు అన్నమాట. సో దట్స్ వై ఐ యామ్ అగైన్ సేయింగ్ జస్ట్ బీ థరో విత్ కాన్సెప్ట్ వాట్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టడీ ఇన్ దిస్ లో ఫ్రీక్వెన్సీ కంట్రోల్. సో దిస్ ఈస్ ద టాపిక్ విచ్ ఇస్ యూజ్ఫుల్ ఫర్ యువర్ ఫైనల్ ఇయర్ ప్రాజెక్ట్. రైట్, దిస్ ఇస్ అబౌట్ టుడేస్ క్లాస్ స్టూడెంట్స్ అండ్ వి విల్ డిస్కస్ ఇన్ టుమారో క్లాస్ దట్ ఈస్ డైనమిక్ రెస్పాన్స్ ఇన్ అన్కంట్రోల్డ్ కేస్. So I'm going to end this class now. Thank you.